look at what I've got. I got my old sparring partner here, Robbie Bronneman,
for the three big questions.
Yeah.
So,
ready.
Robbie, yeah, you ready? So, three big questions. We're going to talk about past, present, and future.
Yeah.
So, when we're talking about past, just curious about something that from your past that maybe put you on your path.
Okay. Right, well, I used to, on my way back from school, drive past this guitar shop, and in the window for about a year was this synth that I was like, just had my eye on. And so I pestered my dad.
Did you know what it was?
Well, I didn't know what it was, and it had brown Tolex covering the whole of it. But I still was interested in it. And I eventually managed to get together the money for it and went and bought it, got it home, realized that there was a synth underneath the Tolex and carefully peeled it all off. And it was a Korg Delta. And that was my first synth, and that was like gave me my love of synths. So yeah.
But not your love of brown Tolex.
No, that gave me my hatred of Tolex forevermore. Tolex and wooden end sheets. So yeah.
Okay, brilliant. So talking present then, what's currently kind of the thing that's floating your boat?
Well, the show, I've loved to see the Super Six, the all Bristol flagship synth. I'm really amazed at how much it feels like a quality instrument. It just feels like something like a Jupiter 8 from the past. Slide, everything feels like amazingly machined and manufactured. Sounds great. So very excited about that. And been very excited to have a proper play a few times on the Hydra synth. I've been back to the booth to have a few plays. So yeah, I think it's a great year for synths.
And these are kind of synths that particularly suit your style, aren't they? So you've been somebody who's who really has embraced digital through the dark era.
Yeah, I think even when I put together my Eurorack was never going to be let's emulate a analog three oscillator synth. So all the modules I chose were carefully chosen to be weird, granular, or loopers, or all this kind of thing. So, it's an amazing time for synths, because although we've got this massive wealth of analog and we've got this just unbelievable sort of accessibility with people like Behringer, we have got this kind of interesting sort of thing that's running alongside it. These kind of the proliferation of wavetable synths and, you know, granular synthesis engines inside hardware.
With lots of hands-on.
With lots of hands-on. Yeah. So, yeah, I think it's a really exciting time because it totally opens it all up again.
Okay, so going into the future, though, what would you like to see happen in the future, or what would you like to be doing in the future more?
Well, I'm starting work on my own project for another artist label.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I just want to be doing much more projects that involve sound design and interesting production, as opposed to just having to do some run-of-the-mill things. So yeah, so that's what's exciting me for the future.
And then in terms of equipment, what would you like to see happen or developments? I mean, we're saying that we like how things are now, but is there something more that you'd like to see happen?
I'm really spoil in that I feel that I pretty much, when I look at my studio, I'm very happy with what I have. So anything I add is really just for new bits of inspiration. I think we're in a golden age of equipment, because there is just so much equipment that people can buy, even at the low end, which is such phenomenal equipment, that really, I mean, you know, I think we're just like, the next two or three years is just going to be, people are just spoilt for choice for great gear. So there's no excuse for bad music.
Excellent. Well, yeah. Robbie, thanks for taking the time, and see you soon. Thank you.